So when you would promote a server as a domain controller,
yep.
In case you face an issue with the during the promotion of a domain controller, there are places wherein logs would be generated for domain controller promotion. These logs would be present under location, which would be C Windows, and under C Windows, your debug folder would be there.
Okay.
Under debug folder, you would have logs such as DC promo, UI, and DC promo. DC promo UI, or let me just. Promo UI, it would contain logs only related to like you promoted it through server manager, right? So any logs that would be related to server manager and any kind of issue that was captured by server manager during DC promo, that issue would be notified under DC promo UI. Okay.
Yep.
And DC promo would contain the complete log for your which for your installation or promotion of a domain controller. Okay. So when you would want to troubleshoot DC promo, you would have to the most important log is your DC promo log, which is present under debug folder. All right. Okay. So we are now logged in onto the server. Over here, I have this option now. Now let's first verify if this domain controller has been joined or not to the domain.
Okay.
Over here now, I can see that the computer name is DC. The full name is dc.a.com. The username with which I'm logged in is Jitin. The login domain is your A.
Yep.
All right. So this means that now I'm able to I can use different administrative tools that are present on this domain controller to manage my resources or manage my security principles. So first thing that I would want to show is where exactly these logs are present. All right.
So, okay. Yep.
As you can see over here, C Windows debug.
Inside
debug folder, you have two logs. One is your DC promo UI, and the second one is your DC promo.
Yep.
When you would open this DC promo, any information associated to what kind of what was the internal working that was happening at that time, you can get it through here.
Right.
All right. What all things that were created and what all things that were done in the background, everything would be present over here. Now, you can see over here that it is stating that creating directory partition. All right. So it is creating all these directory partitions that are being present. Now, that directory partition would not just have this configuration, but also many other partitions associated to it as well. In total, there are four partitions associated to an active directory. We will discuss them later, what they all are. All right.
Okay.
And now, apart from this, there is a few more places, or I can say there is another place wherein you can check for logs if in case you face an issue with DC promo. And that would be your event viewer.
Yep.
Now, under event viewer, when you open application service logs, you see after you have promoted it as or you have added the role of directory service ADDS onto it, this would come up as well. All right.
Yep.
So any issues related to directory service would be present over here. All right.
Okay.
Apart from this, any issue related to your syswall your syswall replication would be over to this DFS replication.
Yeah.
Prior, now you already have 2019, so I believe you have already migrated from FRS to DFSR, right?
Yeah, some of my partners, yes, they are DFSR, yes.
Yes. So usually,
most when of them.
You, yep. Yeah, not most, but you would like, if you already have 2019, that would mean you have
yeah.
already.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, no, for sure. Yeah. But the other ones, I'm not sure. I would have to check because I have many partners. That's,
I'm pretty sure none of the domain controller is now replicating with FRS.
Yeah, pretty sure. Yeah.
Okay. So if not, then there would also be another log over here which would say FRS replication. Now, the FRS was deprecated when 2016 was introduced. Not exactly when the 2016 was introduced, but after some time when it was introduced, right?
Okay.
So administrators were given some time to migrate their syswall from FRS to DFSR because there were few drawbacks associated to FRS.
Yes.
And there were kind of two drawbacks, major drawbacks. One was your journal wrap, and second one was your morphing that was associated. Okay. So under a DFS replication, you would find any issue with the syswall. Under directory service, you would find anything related to your directory services, which is your Active Directory domain services. Okay. Now, if the domain controller is not being promoted, if this domain controller, the first domain controller that I'm promoting, so you would find few things under system as well. You would find few things under application logs as well. All right.
Yeah. Yep.
So these are the three logs which you can check. Okay. Apart from this, as I've told you that it could be that this is not my first domain controller that I have promoted. So let's suppose if I'm trying to, if let's suppose I have a 2016.
Yep.
So let me just mention it over here. Second is your event viewer. Okay. Now, third is, let's suppose I have one domain controller that I have just promoted. It is UK domain controller. Now I would want to promote the America domain controller. But while promoting that, the UK domain controller was a 2016 domain controller.
Okay.
Or I can say 2012 domain controller. And the America domain controller is a 2016 domain controller that I would want to introduce. So while doing that, there is a chance that while promoting this domain controller, I might get some issue. So there are two ways with which that can be done, that can happen. First is because of the schema upgrade, which could happen. Second is your AD prep. Now, previously, what used to happen, we had to do an AD prep manually. But nowadays, we don't have to do AD prep manually. If we don't want to, we can simply introduce the domain controller and it would happen in the background. So there are a few logs that are associated to it that are generated. The logs are present under debug folder.
Okay.
And under debug folder, you would have folder, and under debug folder you would have your AD prep logs,
right? Okay.
So these are so next comes your there is one more location wherein we can see whether there are few logs that are generated over there or not. So where can I find those? Let's suppose I have promoted a domain controller either through PowerShell or through Server Manager. So I can also go under application and service logs. Under application service logs, you see this Microsoft
folder? Yep.
Expand it. expand the Windows folder.
Okay.
Scroll down. And when you would scroll down, you would see this directory service deployment. And under directory service deployment, you have these operational logs. Every role that you would install on the domain on any server, there would be an operational role associated to that. So I have this DNS server role installed on it. So there is an operational there is an operational log associated to this as well.
Right.
All right. So fourth is your operational
logs. Yeah.
So these are the kind of logs with which you can troubleshoot your DC promo issues. Now,
right.
Through these logs, you would be able to identify what exactly the issue is with your domain controller. However, there are few times when you would not be able to understand these logs. Although your searching skills over MSN or TechNet, you might have good searching skills. So you can use those searching skills on Microsoft website to get to know the exact root cause. However, you might require additional information as well from the additional information in order to troubleshoot your issue. So in that case, there are few command line tools that would come up handy.
Okay.
While promoting a domain controller. So that would be your DC DAG tool and your Netmon or Wireshark tool.
Okay.
Okay. Although when you're promoting one, the first domain controller, Wireshark or Netmon would be of no use. Why? Because all the processes are being run internally over the network. There is no communication that is happening. However, when you are promoting an additional domain controller in a domain, then the database, as soon as you would promote the additional domain controller, the complete Active Directory database would be copied from the previous domain controller to the additional domain controller. So if there is a problem while promoting a domain controller or to be exact, while copying the database from UK domain controller to America domain controller, so you can run this Netmon monitor in that case and find out exactly where that issue is.
Okay.
Apart from that, you have this DC DAG tool. This DC DAG tool is a tool which you can use to check the health status of your domain controller. Now, it is a very powerful tool because of which tools like PowerShell have not been able to replace it, because it is a really very powerful tool with which you can check the health of a domain controller.
Cool.
Okay.
I'm gonna film it a little bit with DC DAG. I used it in the past.
Okay.
I had issues with replication at one point. So.
Yeah. Apart from this, you have also one command line tool, which you can use, and that is the repadmins.
Yeah.
Repadmins. So you can use repadmin sync call, you can use repadmin repl sum, you can use repadmin show reps, show repl. There are a lot of repadmin commands which you can use. And while doing a repadmin command, you can take a netmon trace just to capture if the replication between two domain controller is working or not.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Okay. So basically, why I have told you there are so many logs is because usually with one log, you cannot identify where exactly the problem is. Now, if the problem is with internal DC promo, then you can always find out it under DC promo or DC promo UI, or maybe event viewer would be sufficient. But if there is a problem with the functional level upgrade, you may not be able to identify it under domain DC promo log. You would have to check the AD prep logs. It could be that there is an issue with the advertisement of a domain controller. The domain controller has been promoted, but the reason why it is not a domain controller so far, because it is not advertising it as a domain controller. So there might be some service on that domain controller which is not working as it should be. So in that case, the DC DAG would come into picture. There could be that the configuration partition or the domain partition has not replicated. And the reason why it has not replicated, because there could be a lot of reasons. So how would you identify? You can identify that through your event viewer. You can identify that through your DC promo. You can identify that through your netmon trace. All right. So all these logs, they are like, they are for different set of troubleshooting, but they can always come in handy if you know where to get them, right?
Yeah, exactly. Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah. So
you need the logs to find out what's going on.
Yes.
Find these errors. If that wants to see the errors, well, you go from there.
Yep. So usually there is there are failure codes associated to to your DC promo, and those error codes could be mentioned inside the DC promo. And if you get hold of that error code, you can always look up to the Microsoft website to find out what exactly that error code states, or what is the explanation to that error code. Maybe, for example, if you have installed your if you installed a certificate authority on a server already, and you wanted to demote a domain controller, but you're not able to do that. You're using a PowerShell command and you're trying to demote a server as a domain controller so that it won't be a domain controller, but you're not able to do that. How would you be able to find that? You can check the DC promo log. Under that log, there would be an event error code. And that error code would if you would check it online on the Microsoft article, it would suggest that the certificate authority role is installed on that server, because of which you're not able to do that.
Right.
So in that case, what you would have to do, you would have to uninstall that certificate authority role from that machine first, then demote that machine as a domain controller. Got it?
Right. Yeah.
Okay. So now I would run this command netshare on this domain controller. I'm being presented with a lot of shares that are being that are present on this server. Over there, there are two peculiar shares that are now present. One is your netlogon share, and the other one is your syswall share. So if these two shares are not present over here, even if your server has been successfully promoted as a domain controller, it won't advertise as a domain controller. It won't.
Yeah.
So these two shares should be present. Most of the time, when there is no issue, you should check if the server is advertising itself as a domain controller or not. There are two ways with which you can find out. One is your netshare command. The second is your DC DAG. All right.
Yeah.
I hope you are writing it somewhere.
Yeah, I'm writing it right now.
Okay.
I'm taking notes on the side here. So.
Great.
Because I had issues with netlog on this as well, where it wasn't present for some reason.
Okay.
Yeah.
So when I go over to the syswall folder, you see there are four folders over here. One is this domain folder. Under this domain folder, you can see policies and scripts. This policy folder is your syswall folder. And the scripts folder is your netlogon folder. All right. It is your netlogon folder. Any kind of script that you would want to run maybe it is a logon script or anything, you have to keep it under scripts. Any kind of policies that would be there, it would be under policies folder. Now, the policies and scripts folder, or as a matter of fact, the complete syswall are being replicated from one domain controller to the other domain controller via DFS replication if the forest function level is greater than 2008 R2 or 2012 okay. R2. Okay. Microsoft now does not support or does not recommend you to stay on FRS. So apart from this, if you come back, now you would find that you have a syswall folder here.
Yep.
Now, when you open that syswall folder, you find out that there is an a.com file over here. Now, if I open it, there is again policies and scripts folder over here. Now, you have this policies and scripts under domain. So let's create one file over here.
Okay.
I've just created a new text document over here.
Yep.
And I go to the syswall folder under a.com.
Yep. It's there.
I found out. See, replication is always between two domain controllers, not within the domain controller. Now, what I'm trying to show over here is the new text document is created over here as well. It doesn't mean that it has been replicated. It simply means that this syswall folder is none other than a junction point of this domain folder. All right. Yeah. Similarly, the staging folder, you see under staging, you have this domain folder. Under domain, you have this consent set. Similarly, the staging areas is again a junction point of your staging folder. Okay.
Right.
So these two contains the junction points of these two folders. All right.
Okay. Yep.
Now, the one more problem that is associated both with FRS and DFSR is sometimes these junction points are not working properly, because of which you would find there is a discrepancy with the group policies or scripts that are being applied on few users but are not applying on other set of users. When you would troubleshoot, you would find out that the users, the one set of users on which these group policies are being applied, they belong to a different site, and the users with which these group policies are being applied and not applied, they belong to a different site. So in that case, you would find out that the domain controller they are authenticating, basically the problem is with the domain controllers with which they are authenticating. They have a mismatch of their either the mismatch with their syswall, that means that the syswall is not replicating, or these junction points are not working properly.
Right.
So when these junction points are not working properly, sometimes they would get those policies working, sometimes they don't. All right.
Okay.
So now let's we have promoted a domain controller. Now let's discuss the partitions of the domain controller. Okay.